back onto the radar, police arresting the wanted gunman overnight. But he wasn't found here. Instead, officers took him into custody almost 1,000 kilometres away while fleeing the scene of a car crash.
Lying low for more than a month, evading a dogged manhunt, but life on the run is over for Mitchell James Wilson, now in custody, not in Brisbane, but across the border. Police say he was behind the wheel of this black sedan when it crashed in Sydney's southwest overnight. A car he's accused of hijacking after threatening a 38-year-old driver with a gun.
There was an altercation that occurred, and the driver managed to escape from his own vehicle.
It'll be alleged Wilson drove off, eventually slamming into a parked car before fleeing on foot and jumping fence lines in a suburban street.
By this time I confronted him, he jumped over the fence there, but then he came back and started saying some obscenities.
This fugitive, not ready to be found, he walks off, but officers quickly close in.
Cops were here, you know, shortly after that.
Oh, within minutes, they had the, I don't know, what the SWAT squad or whatever, they all had balaclavas and everything. They were ready to go.
Taking the 27-year-old into custody.
This time last month, Queensland police still believed Mitchell James Wilson was likely somewhere in the southeast, being sheltered by members of the community. How he crossed the border and whether he had any help will no doubt be investigated.
Wanted over a terrifying rampage on Brisbane's north side last month, Wilson is accused of firing rounds of bullets at a man's feet in Brendale, setting fire to a Sunnybank home and threatening two women in a Mount Gravatt laneway. The local police will have to wait to lay charges.
And that's because what Queensland Police and their southern counterparts are telling us is that New South Wales court proceedings for Mitchell James Wilson are going to have to be finalised before Queensland Police can apply to have him extradited up here. Andrew, right now we are waiting for an update from New South Wales Police, because as we go to air, no charges have been laid.
Thanks, Lily.